evening is to ensure that the committee runs smoothly, having regard to procedure, behaviour and ethics. To explain who the rest of the people on the tables here tonight are, to my immediate right of the council solicitor, who will give advice to the committee on any procedural or legal matters that might arise. To my left are the council's planning officers, highways engineer and environmental health officer, who will present the application this evening and give any technical advice to the committee that may be sought. The rest of the people who you see down both sides of the tables are the elected members, who will consider the application this evening and make the decisions. Before each application is considered, there will be a short presentation by the planning officers. In the event that an application has received a qualified petition signed by 25 signatures or more, one representative of the petition will be invited to address the committee in support of their petition for up to 5 minutes. If a petitioner addresses the committee, then the applicant or their agent will be invited to make representations to the committee in support of their application, again for up to 5 minutes. However, if a petitioner has not addressed the committee, then the applicant or their agent will not be invited to make any representations. A ward councillor can address the committee in relation to an application. The ward councillor may speak on behalf of the residents. However, once the ward councillor has returned to the public gallery, they may not return to take part in any debate that may be followed by the committee. The application will then be open to debate and discussion by members of the planning committee, who will then make a decision on the application. If a site visit is requested and approved by the committee, that matter will not be discussed this evening and will be discussed at a subsequent meeting. Committee, can I have approval of the minutes on page 1 to 20, please?
Yes, thank you, Chair.
Are there any declarations of interest? Cathy?
Yes, through you, Chair. I'd like to declare an interest in agenda item 8, 51 Ashley Road, as my husband's parents lived at 49 Ashley Road, and I know the object.
Denise?
Yeah, I'm on prejudicial interest, Chair, on Arrow Ball as a low an employee. That's 11 and 12.
Steve?
I'm not prejudicial interest on item 4. I have had any communication with the applicants in my role as a councillor, but I've not made any predetermination about the application.
Okay, and I'd like to declare an interest in agenda item 5, Low Street Police Station. Denise Cook has signed this before me and she will actually chair it for this meeting. Are there any requests for site visits? David?
Yeah, thank you, Chair. I'd like to request a site visit for item 13. This is the development of Federal and Mullery, thereby building that has been surrounded by controversy, and I believe that it would be beneficial for us to visit the site before we take any attempt to decide on that.
Yes, through you, Chair. I'd like to request a site visit for agenda item 6, 77 Piper's Lane. I think it would be beneficial for the community to visit the site.
Okay, so we've been asked for 77 Piper's Lane and for 5 Brimfield Close. Are we happy to agree with?
Yes, thank you, Chair.
So, for the members of the public who are here for those two applications, which is 77 Piper's Lane, Heswall, and 5 Brimfield Close, Heswall, there will be site visits on those.
which sets out each kennel requiring a bedroom of 1.9 square metres, an additional day area of between 2.46 square metres and 3.4 square metres, depending on the size of the dog. At present, only 40 of the existing kennels on site would comply with the required kennel regulations. The site is considered as a previously developed site within the Greenbelt. Taking account of existing buildings, including those to be demolished, together with other developed parts of the site, including hard landings, an increase of 914 square metres in built footprint would result if permission is granted. Given the environmental improvements of modernising the site, and the fact that the use continues to support 22 jobs on site, it is considered that this limited infilling of a previously developed site is acceptable. Although located in the Greenbelt, the National Planning Policy Framework allows for limited infilling and redevelopment of existing sites. As such, the proposed redevelopment of this site is not considered to represent any greater impact upon the openness of the Greenbelt, and the modernisation and environmental improvements that would result from the redevelopment proposed are considered to weigh in favour of allowing the proposals. The proposals are considered to comply with local and national planning policies and are recommended for approval. There is no qualifying petition in connection with this application, and in fact there have been no objections received in relation to the application.
Thank you, Matthew. Is there
a ward
councillor who wants to speak on this?
Yes, thank you, Chair. I do know this site very well, and what is being proposed is obviously an enhancement in some ways, getting this bit run down. So I have great pleasure in supporting the officer's recommendation that this application should be approved because it will improve the facilities dramatically. Thank you.
Any other comments?
Thank
you,
Linda.
Okay, thanks.
Thank you. regarding the change of usage of the old police station at Leech Street. Firstly, I'd like to draw you to the problem of parking on and around the building. I believe and I hope after your site visit you're able to see there are great problems in the future. Secondly, we have grave concern regarding the security and safeguarding of the well-used, popular playground at the rear of the police station. We believe that this could end up being a dumping ground and unsafe for children to play. Finally, I'd like to draw you to the attention of a letter that was handed to me on Tuesday during your site committee. It was handed to me by one of my neighbours, Mr. Lewis, and his son drew up this copy. This letter was forwarded to the planning committee and the local councillors. I'm hoping you've all had a chance to read this, because it goes into greater detail regarding HMO, LHMOs, bed sits, far more information than I could ever bring up. Also, it goes into great detail regarding the parking, again, onto a main lane road, very dangerous, and we believe detrimental to our area. I'm hoping, I can't understand why I received a letter when the original Rose and Shamrock was being pulled down, or sorry, being changed to become another change of usage. No notification has been sent to any tenants or residents in the area regarding the change of the police station. Finally, I'd like to ask you to reject this planning application, and maybe the owner should resubmit the application with all those correct surveys and policies carried out correctly. Thank you.
Thank you, Adam. Is the applicant here? Is the applicant present? No? Ward councillor?
Yes.
Thanks, Julie. Would you like to come down? Thank you, Alan.
Suitable drainage. property with 10 bedsits can only put added stress and exacerbate the situation. The wider issues for the community is around the regeneration of their area. Along Bird Street is a mixed range of family units and not directly planning are related to the change of character, which is likely to ensue from this turning this building into bedsits. Also, Chair, as the committee will have noted from their site visit, this is a very small building, and to house 10 units with only two bathrooms and a very small kitchen seems totally unsatisfactory and completely overcrowded. One must ask what size those bedsits will be, and could only conclude that they won't be big enough for a single person to live in. Whilst residents do appreciate the need for more housing and the crisis which we know about on a daily basis, this is surely not the answer. Thank you.
Thank you, Julie. May I have the opposite question, please? Anybody? Steve?
Yeah, I mean, clearly we went on the sciences, an area I'm well familiar with it. Before you said it, not because I was a frequent visitor to the police station, but because I brought up around that area, and just to add a little bit of local knowledge again, Foulkes Street was the birthplace of the late great Dixie Jean, so I just had that here before I start. However, when I looked at the building, my immediate reaction was, what, 10 people are going to live in that building? It's not a big building, not a large building. We've been here before with applications. The issue about parking, again, we've lamented over many an application. It is on the major transport highway, so the parking rates are relaxed in those circumstances. It is well served by public transport. So for me, the argument is about whether 10 people should be expected to live in that building, what rules and regs, the planning rules will allow us to encourage better accommodation. So I'll be interested to see if there's any sort of real defendable form of words in and around that from many of the other members here. And I know certain members have looked at these type of issues in the past in more detail. So I'll wait for the debate to develop.
Thank you. Anybody else? David?
Yeah, thank you, Chair. Having also been on the site visit, my first reaction was it was an incredibly small building to be housing 10 people. Plus the fact there's absolutely no amenity space around it at all. You've got the boundary walls of the building and that's it. There's nothing else that they can use. The third concern, I think, related to Matthew's description of being five apartments or flats or that sits on each floor, but only one bathroom on the first floor, if I picked that up correctly. That seems to be totally inadequate. It's Dickensian. It's not the sort of thing you should be promoting at this time or encouraging. And I feel that it's just a gross overdevelopment of the site. We've seen a few of these applications before. There's been a variety of HMO applications over the last couple of years, and we've all presided over them at various occasions. But in my view, taking them all into account, this one is just far too small. It shouldn't be allowed to go ahead. I'm not sure what ground we put forward for that, but interested to hear what other people would say. But basically, I just think it's overdevelopment in the site. Thank you, Chair.
We've got Stuart first.
Chair, yes, I'd like to take your interest in that was an impossible application when you come forward and you try and take the time to have a look at the design, etc., or at least the layout on the papers that the architect, the applicant, submits online. I also came across, if you like, the pre-application advice that was given. And I appreciate the pre-application advice would have been in relation to previous intent of the applicant for 12 bedrooms, I think that was. Well, I think there are still a number of points in the pre-application advice that I'm not clear in my mind that have been met. For example, the issue of outlook is discussed in the Prime Officer's letter, and whilst the bedroom numbers obviously will have changed, the clear advice from the Prime Officer is to recommend the layout to be altered so habitable rooms face north towards Laird Street or east towards Fulton Street. In other words, there should be no habitable rooms that face play area to the back. do that. So I'm faced with it be like pre-application advice that has not actually been adhered to. And I guess we enter the realm, if you like, of well, is one room where, well, if advice is worth giving, then surely advice is worth following. So my first concern would certainly be the outlook of one of the bedrooms, at least, over the layout. The second issue that has been referred to is the issue of amenity. Whilst we have no specific policy in HS 14 on amenity, we have debated this at committee on a number of HMO applications, and the general rule we tended to try and set ourselves has been successful at a period. Inspectors have considered the ratio of bedrooms to bathrooms and toilets, and indeed their location within the plan, and come down on our side, despite, I might say, in one case, I can't remember which one it was, quite rude emails about what members of the planning committee had said about the design the applicants put forward. So I was quite delighted with the planning inspector when they said this HMO is reading between the three or four pages of it. I made no such claim necessarily about this one. However, I do know that the ratio of facilities to bedrooms on the first floor in particular, in my view, is inadequate. It matches applications that we've had before and have refused and have been appealed, and we have been successful. Chair, David mentioned inadequate. Steve again was concerned about the overgrowth of the site. I think we've got bags of grounds for tearing this down on those grounds alone. You can't put 10 people into the space. I appreciate the concern that's been made by the residents of the World Council as far as Brighton is concerned. I do know, as Steve was, it's a busy road. It is a busy road that is surrounded by, you know, other places that people will be travelling in their cars to visit, the health centre, etc., and the shopping facilities are close by. So there will be some competition, and I do feel that at some point, I know the chair of the room, I know she has been in contact with planning officers to try and move forward our policy position so far as parking is concerned. But I think all we can hang our hat on, even though it may disappoint the residents at this point, is the fact that it is an overdevelopment. The number of flats that they're attempting to, that's it, they're attempting to squeeze in, is an overdevelopment. And frankly, when I look at this, the test that I apply is, would I, or any of my family, would I like myself or any of my family to live in this? And I looked at it and I decided,
thank you,
Stuart. Ian?
Thank you, Chair. Like Stuart, I looked at this application on paper and a copy of the plan, and like Stuart, the word DOS house came to mind. I can't believe that in this day and age we are being asked to approve an